Start. Ladies and gentlemen, may I wish you a very, very good evening. I don't know about your city, but in Bangalore and in Ahmedabad and in Ludhiana, it is raining cats and dogs. Part of the monsoon, I'm sure, but then also it brings down the heat quite a bit in our respective cities. Today we are gathered because there's a certain concern area. We have already completed two WOW workshops and approximately 600 people attended those workshops. Now, if 600 people attended those workshops and they have already started working, and even if each one has contributed just two UPAs, which by the rules of the company you should have, okay, we should have got 1,200 UPAs. Today in our system, as of this morning, there are 1,889 ACPs. Now, please calculate how much that means. If each ACP were to contribute just two, it would mean almost 3,800 UPAs per month, which would mean approximately 32, 33 per day. That is not happening. Somewhere we felt that we were not reaching across to the ACPs. Somewhere we felt that whatever message that we were deriving was not reaching the people to whom it really mattered. With this in mind, we derived an absolutely new Kautilya, and we made Kautilya something that any officer of Global Gardener would love to participate in. Now, in order to do that, we wanted everyone to really understand, especially the assistant channel partner, we wanted him to understand what kind of a gold mine he's sitting on. And we wanted him to understand, him also means her. We wanted him or her to understand that by not doing anything, okay, or by doing just a little, they themselves are the ones who are the biggest losers. Today, in a very brief session, what Vikas is going to do is he's going to explain to you what are the two documents we need you to fill before you all attend the next Kautilya. Okay, and those documents are a prerequisite. You cannot attend the Kautilya unless you have those documents with you. Now, how we are going to do it, what we are going to do, all this your state head will explain to you either tonight or early in the morning tomorrow. But right now, what you need to do is pay full attention to what Vikas is saying, because at the end of 30 minutes, ladies and gentlemen, believe me, you're going to hit yourself on the head and say, "Achcha, na ennathik idu pannala, na yak madlilla idu." Okay, now this is what is going to be your feeling. After his session, if there is time, we will invite a few questions only on today's topic. Please understand that if there's any other question, with my apologies in advance, I will stop you from asking the questions. Only on today's topic, if you've not understood anything, you're welcome to ask Vikas questions. So without any more ado, let's get the ball rolling. In front of you, Vikas Rawat.
Thank you very much. Thank you very much, Ray. Again, the purpose of this this small exercise is that we want to set the gold right, because we feel that we have almost 1800 people with us, but I think the goal setting has not been done, because in morning also we saw that many of the CP and ACPs were not even able to recognize the sheet that we are showing them. I think this sheet has been sent to everyone. It is the part of the knowledge bank that we have given, but still people are not practicing it. Because if you do not tell a person what he can gain from Global Gardener, he is not going to put that 100% that we want him to put in, right? It is really important for a person to know what he is going to gain from the time he is investing in Global Gardener, right? So let's first see what is the goal setting sheet. I think this has been circulated to all, but still I will again go into this and again tell you what two documents are required for you to present before you get into Kautilya. So this is the first one. All you need to do is, when as a CP you are recruiting a ACP, you have to set this goal sheet. What you need to ask in this goal sheet is, first question, what is the population of the pin code that he wants to have? So let's say he says 50,000, and just ask him, okay, let's assume that you are working with this 50,000 families or population, and by the year end, in 12 months time, how many users do you think will come to us? Because as a user, we are giving only two choice to a user: come with Global Gardener and get cashbacks, go without Global Gardener and you get guaranteed zero. So we think that 100% user will come to us, because India is pro saving country. We believe in saving a lot. Even when that 0.8 paisa or 0.80 paisa is increased in petrol, we go and get our petrol tank full, right? So if Global Gardener is giving such a fantastic cashback option, everybody would like to come. But let's assume that it is only 50% consumer that will come in Global Gardener after 12 months. Whatever we are talking, it's post 12 months. Let's say now ask him, whom you are making an ACP, ask him. First of all, when you are asking him, actually he should have gone through the wow. Because without wow presentation, he would not know what are these potential income. Why people will become a vendor of Global Gardener? Why people will come and become a user of Global Gardener? Because this goal sheet cannot be done without wow. So first, take him through the wow presentation and post that, ask him, how many vendors do you think will become a vendor of Global Gardener at free of cost? Ask him what number that you think that you will make vendor every month. He says 15, 18, 20, whatever. Multiply it by 12. Put that number here. Ask him, how much commission do you feel that a vendor will give you? On an average business of almost 1.5 lakh, you will be able to fetch almost 10,000 rupees commission. Ask, how many UPAs do you think a partner can sell in a month? I think there is no number less than one. So just put one here. And now show him what is the income potential that he has. It's 11,60,550 rupees, which is excluding his own UPAs income, which is excluding the extra revenue that UPAS is going to earn, because we have taken a very conservative number of 1 lakh rupees for a UPAS. And if still he does such a small job, as a ACP, he is earning 11,60,550 rupees. This is something really big for him. Now you can ask him, does he have any plan on even paper, from where he can earn this much? I think he will have no plans, right? On the same sheet, on the same performance, you as ACP can see your own goal setting also. On same performance, you are earning almost 30 lakh rupees a month and 12 lakh rupees in next 12 months. So which is almost 1 lakh rupees a month and 30 lakh rupees thereafter. And this income is coming through garnering of the economy. He might not be selling UPAS anymore after 12 months. But because he has garnered the economy, UPAS will keep on trading, vendor will keep on trading, users will keep on trading, and the benefit will go to an ACP. Right? This is how simple it is to set your goals. Then once you have done this, go on the next sheet, which is the roadmap, because now you have shown him what is the potential income that he has. Now you set the goal right, the roadmap. Because first of all, he needs partner, that is team. Ask him, what is the team size that he is looking forward to? In July, August, September, give him 3 months time to recruit his team. 1 month's time, 2 months time, whatever time he wants. Because to recruit a team of 10 people, he required to induct only 2 people per day. If only 2 people are inducted per day, he will, in 15 days, he will have 30 people inducted. And among these 30 people, he can easily choose the top 10 guys for his partnership, right? Then ask how many UPOs he wants to sell, how many vendors he wants to sell, and set this goal sheet. This is a very simple roadmap. This will not take more than 30, 40 minutes. As a CP, if you are able to do this much only, because user is not your problem. User will be brought in by UPOs and the vendors. I have seen that ACPs are working on user also. ACPs are working on getting the cashback into the system for user cashback. It is not your job. As a CP, you are not inclined to sell UPOs. As a CP, your job is to only and only and only to recruit ACPs. Rest job is to be done by ACPs. Vendor and users have to be brought in by ACPs. Users acquisition has to be done by vendor and UPOs. This is the smallest exercise that we want you to do to earn this much amount. Now, when you will be doing this goal setting, there would be people who will ask you, sir, if not 50%, let's say even 5% users come into the system, only 5%, 95% people are not coming, not 210, one, let's say you, I recruit only 5 vendors per month, not 10,000, I get only 5,000 rupees per month. One UPOS, not one UPOS, it's 0.2 UPOS, which means one partner is selling one UPOS in a year's time. One partner selling one UPOS in 365 days. Then also that ACP would be earning almost 1.5 lakh rupees with such a pathetic performance. And this is one month on month income that he will be having. And on same performance, CP will also be earning 5 lakh rupees a month. On such a low number, 5% users, only 5 vendors per month, and selling one UPOS in a year's time by partner. Ask him, do you have any job which can give you 1.5 lakh rupees on such a low performance? And after 12 months, you might not be selling UPOS. It cannot get even smaller than this, right? It is as simple as that. I have seen people asking me, sir, why should an ACP buy a UPOS? ACP should have his UPOS. We do not make it compulsory, but ACP should have his UPOS because you are the coach. You are there to sell UPOS only. If you yourself will not have that UPOS training, how will you sell UPOS? And buying UPOS is, and earning from UPOS is the easiest thing that you can have. We have already shown you the UPOS calculator. I am again going to show you how simple it is to earn from UPOS. So now let's say you are going to a vendor and asking him to become your vendor. Tell him that I will give you UPOS for free. Who will not like to become your vendor? And tell him that because I have invested in UPOS, I will take 50%, you also take 50%. He will be earning 23 lakh rupees per month even if he has only 100 users. Only 100 users. His earning with, along with my circle cashback and the incentive would be approximately 1.29 crore without even a single penny investment. But he is also giving you an income of 23 lakh because 50% is coming to you also. So even if you make him an agent in your UPOS and he is not buying a UPOS, then also he is giving a huge profit to you. Huge profit. But if you want to sell him a UPOS, you can just tell him that, sir, this 23 lakh is not your profit, this is your loss. Why? Because just by not buying your own UPOS, you are giving 23 lakh to me, because we are 50-50 partner. So if you are earning 23 lakh, that means I am also earning 23 lakh from this, right? Because we are equal partners. Same ways when a person is buying a UPOS and just make agents. Let's say you yourself are not making any user. Make it totally zero. Then also your earning is 1.49 crores on UPOS. Even if you make everything zero, your own contribution to user is zero. Your sale is on zero on every parameter. Only we are taking one parameter, which is grocery. Then also you are earning 6.48 lakh rupees every year on your UPOS when you are not contributing even a single user in a month, not even a single user. Then also this is the earning. So by any means, the income is huge, but it is totally up to you how you are using this platform. So what we want you to do in Quartalia is, whoever is participating in Quartalia, he has to do his goal setting and we will do the screening. All you need to do is just ask them to do a goal setting. First, on the Excel that we have given. Second is the roadmap. These two documents are compulsorily to be submitted to HO for him to get a gate pass for the Quartalia this time. Because we do not want to induct anybody who is not very well versed with three things. One is wow. Second is the goal setting. Third one is the roadmap. If a person is not knowing these, we are not going to induct that person for sure. Now over to Ramesh Bhai and we take questions now. If you have any questions, just raise your hands in your app and I will ask you to unmute and ask the question.
Yeah, thank you so much, Vikas. Those people who would like to ask questions, please use your own tool at the bottom of your screen or raise your hands if you're on video. And you can ask the question. If the question is related to what Vikas has said today, we certainly will allow it. Please go ahead.
It's a question.
Prabhudev, yes.
Yeah. Sir, I completely understood what it has been told today, but how will be, supposing if I'm talking to a new ACP, who's supposed to going to be ACP, is the timetable is accommodative for WoW meeting and Kautilya meeting, sir? Supposing if I'm talking to a person today, how will be able to accommodate for him for the meeting?
May I answer?
Yeah, please.
Yeah, Prabhudev, what you can do is get your prospective ACP to watch the basic program. Okay.
Okay.
First, ask him to watch the basic program.
Okay, sir.
And then I'm sure tomorrow, day after, there is going to be some WoW somewhere in the country. Let him go through this.
Okay, sir.
Now, once he goes through this, he will understand the process of goal setting, and it will take you just about half an hour to teach him how to go ahead with his goal setting. And then he can attend other programs too. He can attend Kautilya also, provided two things. He must have gone through WoW and he should have done his goal setting.
All right, sir.
Right.
Thank you, sir.
All right. Next.
Mr. Abdul Riaz, you can unmute yourself.
Yeah. ACPs can enter the market only after the Kautilya training, isn't it?
Right.
Okay, right. That was the question. Thank you.
Next question.
Mr. Javed Negi, you can unmute yourself.
Good evening.
Yeah.
When will be the next Quartalia session, may I ask?
Post this exercise, we'll tell you the date.
approximate, because I need at least 1 or 2 days to train my ECPs.
Once you have done this, most probably by Monday, we'll start Kautilya.
Thank you.
Because we will do one-to-one screening before Kautilya. And once we do the screening, then only we'll allow that person.
So, thank you.
Yeah, Mr. Prabhudeva, you can unmute yourself. Mr. Abdul Riaz, if you have a question, you can unmute yourself.
Yep. Looks like there are not many questions.
Is it necessary? There is someone in the chat who is asking, is it necessary for all ACPs to buy a UPERS? Of course, it is not necessary, but you tell me one thing. You want to become a coach of cricket. Can you teach how to bat without a bat? Whenever someone is asking me this question, I always ask this. You want to become a teacher and you don't want to graduate. Because if you yourself are not convinced on UPOS, because UPOS is the powerhouse of earning. And if you yourself are not convinced on UPOS, how you are going to convince anybody else? Because anyways, as a company, we are asking an ACP to sell UPOS, not to buy UPOS. Compulsion is off to sell UPOS, 2 UPOS in a month through his team. That is compulsory. We are not making it compulsory to buy a UPOS. But the question is, how are you going to sell UPOS without a proper knowledge of a UPOS? Because let's say your prospect says that, okay, you tell me how this UPOS works. And you will tell, okay, I'll ask someone to come and that person will show a UPOS to you. He will definitely ask why you are not having your own UPOS. Because getting the India's entire ecosystem to sell, and that is almost peanut cost. And if you yourself are not doing that, why are you asking me to do it? Secondly, if you have your own UPOS, it will be much easier for you to sell UPOS, because first of all, you can make that guy an agent in your system. Once he gets that filler of first income from UPOS as an agent, he is going to definitely buy a UPOS from you, because he will not let that 50% come to you because it is his money. So even if he earns 5,000 rupees a month, he will buy his own UPOS, because even buying UPOS in a EMI will not cost him more than 2,000 rupees. So he will not give you 5,000 rupees like that. He will buy his own UPOS. So therefore, it is compulsory for you to have a UPOS, not because company is saying, because you have to sell it.
Because I would like to pose as a prospective ACP. Okay, and I would like you to do my goal setting for me.
Okay. Go ahead.
Can you please go ahead, please share your screen on goal setting with me?
Yeah, I will do that. Yes. Just hold on.
Okay.
Just hold on. Okay. Now you can tell me the population of your PIN code.
Yeah, in my PIN code, you're right, because there's no PIN code less than 50,000. So that PIN code figure remains the same. However, you're talking about population. I would like to say that out of this population of 5,000, there will be about maybe 1,200 families.
Okay.
Okay.
Oh, it is 50,000 population. So if you divide by 4, so it will be
approximately
12,500.
All right, 12,500 families. Okay.
Right.
Now, the user percentage, I'm saying, let's make it 3%.
Okay.
Okay. The average vendors in a PIN code, I belong to a semi-rural situation. So I don't think I'll have 60 vendors in my PIN code. that let us presume I'll have 20.
Okay.
And my average vendor commission, the commission that I will get per vendor, okay, will be just about 3,000 rupees.
Okay.
Okay. Now, the average UPOS per month that my partners will sell or I will sell in a year's time, I will say 5 in a year.
5 in a year means 0.5 in a month.
Let's say six in a year.
0.5 in a month.
0.5 in a month. Okay. Now, the average income per UPOS, I would also like to bring that down to, let me say, 50,000 rupees per UPOS.
Okay.
Now,
this is your income.
This is, now, my net income is about 90,000 rupees per month. Right. And my one-term income is about 1,20,000.
Right.
Okay. Ladies and gentlemen, we are talking about the bottom end of our assistant channel partners. In the southern states, I don't think there is any PIN code which has got less than what we are looking at on the screen now. But please also understand that if somebody is in such a small place, his cost of living is also very low. And for him to get 89,550 rupees per month is a huge sum of money, because his expenses are not going to be anywhere near that amount. Have you understood what becoming an assistant channel partner is all about?
And on, just to add on, if a CP has all his 10 PIN codes of such a low population, still CP would be earning almost 5 lakh rupees a month.
So the CP earns 5 lakh rupees.
Whereas, course, yeah, sorry.
Sorry, I'm so sorry. This is theoretical, because a CP will definitely have some good ones and maybe some not so good ones as far as PIN codes are concerned. But even if you take the bottom of the scale, good God, an ACP earns so much of money. A CP earns so much of money. Good God, this is really great.
And again, I will put this number. This 3% will 100% be more than 50%, because India is pro-saving country. We are inclined towards saving things. So this will not be 3%, because this is an elite class who might come and say 3%. But we have the majority, which is in middle class segment. And if that middle class segment is told about this concept, they are definitely going to come in, because there is no investment for them. There is no risk for them. They only have one thing to gain, is that is they are only there to gain. Right? So even if we take 50% of this, and I don't think so, in the year's time, an ACP will recruit 20. Let's take 60 as number, and UPOS income we have shown many times, but I'm not going to increase it. Still, your income becomes 2.72 lakh rupees. As an ACP, I have not done much. I have just changed population to 50%, and now let's do it zero. Population zero, vendor zero. As an ACP, still you are earning 75,000 rupees, which is still a very good income without you doing anything. So now when you will do that goal setting, no, the roadmap. Now when you will ask that ACP how much time he is going to invest daily, people are going to tell you adequate time. Secondly, n number of times people tell me that this is not a job, that people should report us, this and that. I always tell them this is even better than a job, because in job it is every month you have to perform, every month 9 to 9 you have to work. There is no future income that you are creating. This is your business. You do it only 2 hours daily. Post 12 months you will not be doing a job with anybody. So you have to explain to that guy that this is even bigger than what job you are doing. Then only he is going to give you time. Because he has to understand what he is getting from Global Garner. Till now, people have not understood what Global Garner is all about. It's a huge and immense potential of income. I again bet on this. You have spent lakhs and crore rupees in setting up your business, doing your studies, and still there is no income guarantee. There is still a probability of loss. But in global Gartner business model, you don't have any business loss. Even slightest of the thing, there is no business loss. This is business, but it is not with risk. With such a small performance, 0.5%, matlab 6 you pause in a year's time. And I think we are talking to a territory which has two performers who have sold 10 UPAs in just 1 month's time. And they have been promoted in Tamil Nadu, right? So we know what you all have already done. It is just that everybody should know what it is there for them. Yeah, over to Navin.
Could we go off the screen? Ladies and gentlemen, we have time for a couple of questions before we go on to closing. Anybody needs to ask any question?
Yeah, good evening. I'm Ketan Upadhyay.
Ketan, go ahead.
Question to Vikas and you. I have a SCP who is a corporate, I mean, in a firm's name, right? So can the Kautalya be attended by two or more members?
Done their goal setting and everything, we have no issue with that.
Fine, thanks.
The only requirement this time with Kautilya is three. One, he should have attended WOW. Second, he must have gone through his goal setting. Third, he has his roadmap.
Fine. So the WOW has already been done. The roadmap and the goal setting is yet to be done. So once it is done, so why I am insisting on this, so that they can talk to more people, right? So right, instead of one person, there are two or three people are talking on creating the partners and
with that.
Fine. Thanks, sir.
All right. One more question. Right.
Hi. This is Priya Gumprachi. Yeah, because yesterday I have been in the celebration and it was good. Nice to be...
Ma'am, we are not getting your voice clearly.
I'm doing it. Oh, okay. Wait.
Go ahead, Priya. Go ahead. Please talk to us.
Okay, fine. Okay, wait a minute. I'll come.
Sure.
I don't know why the voice is not audible.
No, it is now. It is good. It is now good.
Is it now audible?
Yeah, it is audible now.
Okay, fine. Thank you. Actually, I'm eagerly joined and took the UPAS immediately when I came to know about Global Corner. But the thing is, I'm just struggling to know each and every site among the Global Corner, and getting all the details is very tough for me. Even I am attending too much of meetings, I couldn't get. Why not? It could be easier. So that CPs and ACPs can be easily get... it's humble suggestion. I'm also attending, but I'm not getting your cut. Until now, I don't have any clear. That's why the.
So, ma'am, what we can do is we can arrange.
And we have a good systematic or start.
Okay. So, we can do is we can arrange only a training for you on UPAS. So, okay. If you can ask your state head, which state do you belong?
Tamil Nadu.
Okay, Tamil Nadu. Great. So, I think already there are many people who can train you on that. If not,
sorry, Priya.
Priya,
you can talk to us later on. You can talk to any one of us later on. We'll only be too happy to take care of your inquiry. You seem to have a bad connection, so we're not able to hear you very well.
I don't know why. Thank you.
You can take my number from anybody in Tamil Nadu, no problem, or you can take Vikas's number. Please talk to us later on. All right.
Yeah, okay. Sure. Thank you so much. I don't know.
Ladies and gentlemen, before we leave today, there's a very important announcement I have to make. All the states. Now we have divided India into 14, our kind of states. And all the ACPs of all the 14 states are meeting us over the next 3 days. And these meetings are going to be as per your state, your state head will be there, your MCP will be there, the CP will be there, and the ACPs will be there. What is the objective of this meeting? The objective of this meeting is to find out whether every ACP has completed his goal setting or not. Whether every ACP has completed his ACP roadmap or not. Now, here's the request. All of you who are present here, please make sure that you pass the message to your brother CPs, to the MCPs who are not here, and definitely to the ACPs, that over the next 3 days, most probably Tamil Nadu and Karnataka are meeting us tomorrow, Andhra is also meeting us tomorrow. The exact schedule is available with your state head, and he will communicate to all of you. Now, we will be meeting all of you, and the purpose is just to say hello, meet you, and definitely get to know whether you've filled your format or not. Now, this is a date that you need to have with us. Those of you who are channel partners only and have not climbed to MCP, please understand that this kind of an opportunity comes only once in a lifetime. You are occupying a very, very important place in an organization that is going to be 6 lakh crores. Okay, in just about 2 years, 1 year or a little more than a year. Okay, now the kind of benefits that accrue as you keep growing in the organization is something even beyond my own imagination. And I know it is definitely beyond your imagination. Vikas has showed you the bottom of the scale, where a person doing very little work, how much he can earn. Now, when a person does everything that he is expected to earn, he is looking at an income of at least a crore of rupees per day, per month. Okay. Now, this is something we have not shown you because you might think, I don't know, this is something we ordinary people cannot do. We have definitely brought you down to the most conservative levels. What Vikas has showed you can be achieved by just 2 hours of work every day. Okay. And those 2 hours, what you need to do is simply and simply nothing else, motivate your ACPs to do the actual job. If you are able to convince them, support them, inspire them to do their job, whatever the ACP earns, you're also a partner in their earning. We leave you with just that thought. What you're seeing of Global Gardener is a very small tip of the iceberg. As we go on, each one of us in this family is going to benefit exponentially, not only in money, but in terms of our own being together, bonding together, becoming friends, becoming part of a movement called Global Gardener. With a hearty note of thanks to Vikas, all the state heads who are present here, the MCPs and the CPs, ladies and gentlemen, let me wish you a good night. And I hope to see you, or rather, Vikas, Raman, and I hope to see you over the next 3 days, along with your ACPs. And please, from today onwards, please, please, please understand that the more effort you put now, the faster are the rewards you'll get. With that small note, let me wish you all a very, very good night. Thank you so much.